Hi everyone, welcome to Build Your Advanced Deal IQ. My name is Ashley and with me today are my colleagues Emmy and Bogdan, and today Emmy will be covering part two of customizing object presentation and labeling. Thank you so much for taking time out of your day to be here with us. This will be our last webinar of 2016, but we will be back in February next year. Before we get started, please feel free to leave questions in the chat window and we'll answer them as best we can. This session will be recorded and links are available in the registration reminder, the post-webinar survey, and in the chat window. And again, today we'll be covering part two of customizing object presentation and labeling. We'll start with a recap of the part one webinar, then we'll get into object labeling, and then at the end, of course, we'll have some time for live Q&A. Emmy, are you ready to show everyone how this works in Advanced Deal?
Yes, thank you, Ashley. Hi, everyone, and thank you for being here. Thank you for your time. We will start with a short summary of the previous webinar of the part one. We discussed about the Drawing Style Manager, the interface that allows us to see, edit, use and customize all the drawing styles from Advanced Deal. And we went to the object presentation branch on this dialog, which looks a bit complicated with all these rules. But if we go further, we see that the key point, the first key in customizing the drawing styles, is the model objects, meaning to identify the elements, the objects, based on their properties, element type, model role, and filter. So it's the combination of these three properties that allows us to define the model objects. Further, the second key in customizing is the position in detail, the object position in detail, which means how the detail is positioned and seen in the detailed drawing, the geometric restriction, how it is placed from top, from bottom, linear, non-linear, and then depth position, which is the Z position of the object relative to the main object of the detailed drawing. Together, the combination of model object, of objects based on their properties, and the geometric restriction and the position, so the objects based on their position in detailed drawings, creates the identify the object in detailed drawing. And this is the key point in customizing drawing styles. If we are able to identify the object in the detailed drawing, then we can go further to presentation, we can assign a labeling rule, and even more than that, the same combination of object identified based on properties and position in detail is used for dimension request to customize your dimensions. That will be a part of a different webinar. Next, we discussed about presentation rules, meaning how the element is shown in the detailed drawing, the color assignment for each part of the object, body visible, the visible lines, the hidden lines, axis, and so on, and the body representation. I would like to add something more on the presentation rules. I'd like to have an example that I didn't show you last time. In order to emphasize the importance of presentation rules regarding the body representation. As you can see, we have three columns: element, color, and representation. As long as we don't have anything on the column representation for body visible, it means that the element will be shown with its standard presentation. Let's see how it goes in advanced DL. In our model, I have added a folded beam. So a custom shape, I created a custom shape, then I created a folded beam. You can see here, and I placed a shortening on it. Let's go to drawing styles, and to create a single part drawing, like for any other beam, I will use the drawing single part beam front top button. Use. Okay, and let's open the detail. And we can see that the element was shown with its visible lines and with hidden lines, and we can see it's exactly like in the 3D model. If we go to drawing styles and let's go to object presentation and see the rules. We have all the rules and our element is a folded beam. We go to the presentation rule and we see it's visible hidden. And exactly like that is shown in the detail drawing. Let's change that to visible unwinded hidden system. What it means? We see that at this point the representation of the body visible is unfolded. Let's use it. Apply, use, and we can see that the top and bottom views of the element are shown as unwinded. So this is how you can get a different representation of the element. It's the same drawing style, the only thing that I've changed was the object presentation. Another option that is important for this part is to have the visible exact. This one is very useful when you have double T or channel section and you want to see them in the detailed drawings when you see their section with fillet radius to see exactly the flange slope and so on. This is the exact representation. This is how you do. All right, so I will get back to visible hidden presentation to not affect my original drawing style. Okay. Let's go now to our next part, which is the object labeling. Sorry for that. We go to drawing styles, drawing style manager. Let's go to our previous drawing style in for assemblies, and we choose the beam, beam front, object presentation, and we see a lot of rules here. Let's check for main part beam. Okay. So we have the object, main part beam, we have the presentation rule, and the labeling rule is off at this point. I will change it for us in order to be able to use Labeling strategy. On this page, we have all the options that allows us to customize the labeling to specify all the properties. It looks complicated and it has quite a lot of options in one page, and all of them are creating, are combining the labeling strategy. So the entire, in order to be able to use it, you know, we can change how we look at this page. For that, the entire labeling strategy can be structured. So let's see in on this part. We have the entire page, and the labeling strategy, this name, contains the entire configuration, and all the properties can be structured in three main sections. One is the general properties. General properties that applies to all to these labels. The next section, the label content. This is the content, how the label is, the text that will be shown in the detailed drawing. And after we have the properties and the label content, we have the next section, which is the label arrangement in the detailed drawing, how the label will be shown in the detailed drawing. Let's see in advanced deal. We will discuss each option one at a time for each section. So for the general property section, on this part, the first one is text direction and combining labels. It means the maximum distance that will be used to combine two labels. You have, if you have two identical elements in the detailed drawing, the labels will be identical. If those two objects will be closer in the detail than this distance, then the two labels will be combined in one label and will be shown as 2 multiplied and the label content. If we say 0, then the labels will not be combined. Let's let it as it is. Next, the text direction. This option will set the angle for the text in the reference system, and usually it's 0, but this is very helpful when you want to create a label at a specific angle, for example at 45 degrees, if you have if you see only the section of an element, you don't see its axis, and this can be quite helpful. Next option, place along the object. The name is quite meaningful, self-explanatory. It means that the label will be oriented according to the object position in the detailed drawing. If the element is horizontal, the label will be horizontal. If it's skewed, the label will follow that. If we don't activate this option, the label will be created horizontally, or actually will be created according to this angle. Next option, arrange beam label according to compass. This option allows us to show the member orientation in the general arrangement drawings, the orientation relative to the compass, the object compass that we inserted in the 3D model. The orientation is based on the shop drawing orientation. It's not very intuitive at the first, so hopefully I'll have enough time to have a demo to show you how it works exactly. It's relatively important, especially for US market, because it's used for US market quite a lot. And the behavior can be sometimes tricky. Next one, leader line. It's obvious the label will be created with or without leader line. Next one, the last general property is the visibility status. Default, visible, visible and hidden. This option allows us to specify to the label strategy when should work for which elements. For the visible elements or for the hidden elements or for any elements meaning visible and hidden or for the default. What means the default? The default is the option from management tool. Hidden drawing labeling. If that option is set to default, the label strategy will work according to this option. Enable labels for hidden object. If this option is not active, then the label strategy will place a label only for the visible object. If it's activated, the label strategy will work for any object, visible and hidden. This option is it's quite good, especially when you want to differentiate between visible and hidden object, when you want to create a different label for the hidden object. All right, that was the general section part in our presentation, in our section general properties, and now we can go to label content. For the label content, here we specify the subtemplate, the definition of the label content, the text, and how it's shown in the detailed drawing. Most of the properties, position, function, font, text height, and so on, are very, I suppose, they are very familiar with you from a detailed drawing. Because it's the same one, let's open our detail. Let's open any label. Here are the same options. The tokens, the function, bold, all the options that are available for in this option, in this label designer dialog box. What is different and what is important in this case in when you customize. The label content rule, it's a sub-template of the labeling strategy. And this is the name of the label content, of the rule. Why it's important? Because if you change anything in this mark and centered content, you will not affect only this label strategy. You will affect all the labeling strategies that are using this subtemplate mark and centered. So just be aware when you want to modify the content of a label, either you are aware that you are changing all other labels that are using this rule, this subtemplate, or you create a new one specific for your label strategy. Second point that is important on this section is used for object. From here you can specify for which object should work this labeling strategy, this label strategy. The content label is defined, you can define it for any object or you can specify I want to work for concrete beams or for attached beams or for bolts. The main consequence when you change, when you select this object, is the content of the tokens. The list of tokens at this moment is full. It means that all the available tokens are displayed in this drop-down list. For example, gauge, head diameter, or depth position and commodity number, all of them. If I change the object, so for example, I would like to create a labeling strategy only for the bolts, in that case, the content of the list is way shorter, because it will allow, it will show me only the tokens that are available for bolts. Okay, let me go back to my original. Okay. In the rest, I would like to reinforce that at this point, when you are customizing your labeling, is the second phase, is the next phase after you completely identify the object that you want to use. So it makes sense to configure the label for a specific object, because at this level you already know that you are working for you are customizing a label strategy for beam or for polybeam or for plates. Yeah. Okay, that was the second part, label content. After that, after you have defined the label content and you know all the, you have specified all the general properties, the next section is the label arrangement. How the label is arranged in the detailed drawing. And in advanced steel, we have two methods how to place the label inside the detailed drawing around the object. One is based on area, and one is based on angle. When we specify, the options are different for each method, with some options that are common. Let's see, for based on area method, let's open the dialog and see the available options. All the options are saved in a subtemplate, label placing rule. This is the name, and all these options are saved in this subtemplate. Let's discuss the option. Arrange in object center. You can see in the picture what is doing. When this option is activated, the label will be arranged in the object center. When is not active, then the label, the process will follow these steps to find a suitable place. And let's discuss now about the iteration steps. For each step, the process will try to define, to find an area around the object, a rectangle around an object, where the label should be placed. And we have the search area, left, right, top, bottom. You can specify, or inside, even inside the object when you have, for example, a plate, and you want to, you can specify to find a suitable place inside. Usually, you use right, top, left, bottom. Area percent, according to the beam length. For example, in this picture, you can specify to not search a suitable place for the entire length. You can specify to search only for 75% of it. And the minimum distance and the maximum distance of this rectangle, the dimension of this rectangle perpendicular to the object. And you have, you can define different steps with different options, different areas or different minimum distance and maximum distance. For each rule, specific area will be identified, will be searched and hopefully identified for placing the label. Then you have a this option. If an allowable position is found at any step, the search will not be continued. This is good because if you activate it, the search will go for each step until one position is good, is found. If a good position is found, then the search will not continue with the rest of the steps. You will have speed increase because of that. Will save time. The downside, if you want, is that will not search is not the optimum result. You can get a better result, for example, if you let all the steps to be searched. The next option, the total geometry must not be overlapped, not just the local geometry. The label placing process will try to find a suitable place without overlapping the object itself. When we activate this option, the process will search for an option taking into account all the elements, not just this local element, not just the labeled element, but also the surrounding elements. And those are the options, all the options for arrangement, label arrangement, for the method based on area. You will find a very good article with additional explanation about label arrangement methods. We will provide you the link for that. Let's go to the other method based on angle. The main difference, is that the method based on area will try to find a rectangle, an area where the label should be placed. In this case, based on angle, you specify the angle of the leader line that should be searched, the direction and the angle of the leader line, and then you specify the minimum distance and maximum distance that should be used to find a suitable place. This is called old method. It's much slower than the other method. It might be very good in case of that you want to specify a specific angle for search. And yes, indeed, it works very nice. The options are, some of them are similar. If an allowable position is found at any step, the search will not be continued. It's the same one from the other method. If a good position is found at step one, then the other search will not continue. Again, another one. This is an option that is not found in the other part. If a position closer than max distance is not found, select the basic position. When a good position, allowable position is not found, when you have mean distance and max distance, what should do? If the option is activated, then the label will be placed in a basic position, in the hard-coded distance from the object. If is deactivated, then the search will continue and will try to find a good place at this angle, 45, regardless the maximum distance. Next option, the total geometry must not be overlapped, not just the local geometry, is the same as the other one, with to take into account also the surrounding elements. There is an additional option for this one. The preceding sign of the search angle is of no importance. It means that we'll search for the angle 45, but also for minus 45. So you can simplify the rule by using this one. Additional, we have the label arrangement relative to object. Do not arrange in center of the object, or arrange the object center, arrange in object center using these steps, or arrange directly in object center like in the area without doing any step, and that's it. It's really fast. Okay. So those are the options relative to label arrangement. And with that, we conclude the label arrangement, the labeling strategy presentation. What I want to emphasize again is that the key point in customizing drawing styles is to identify the object in the detailed drawing based on object properties and based on its position in the detailed drawing, geometry, position, and depth position. At this point, I would like to, since we have enough time, I would like to show you the effect of this option, arrange beam label according to compass. So for that, I will close this model for the moment, and I will open another model, quite a big model, not big, a more complex one. And I have created a 3D view for it. And you can see, first of all, let's see, we have created the, using the drawing style, one 3D view model labels. This is the drawing style used for creating this, this drawing. If we go to its definition, we have object presentation and the labeling rules. If we go to main part, let me open again the detail, we see that all the main parts have a label. So it means that this is the rule to create a label. We go labeling rule, mark and name. And we can see that this option is activated. This is a default drawing style from US installation. Arrange beam according to compass. Okay. Let's insert a compass in the 3D model. And we can, let me update the detailed drawing just to be sure that the labels are taking into account the compass. So we see the compass here, we see the orientation, and we see the labels. We see that this beam has the label placed in this beam end, at this side, not on the other side. This beam end is the one, the same one that you can find it in the detailed drawing when you create the assembly drawing for this beam. Let me update the detail. And sorry for all these dimensions and so on. I will erase them because I don't want to interfere too much with what I want to show. This is the orientation. So in the assembly drawing, we see the compass. It's placed on this side, and this is the end, the orientation of the beam that you have it here. Now, if I move the label in this position and I update the detail, it will take some time. On my system, it's not very fast. We see that the label remains in place. It's in the same position. Let's move the label on the other side of the beam, on the other half, and update the detail again. Okay, it's doing update, and we can see that the label was moved back to its original position. Why? Because if we let it here, then we'll be in conflict with the label setting. We'll contradict this option, arrange beam label according to compass. This is particularly important when you want to know why some labels are moved after you have finalized all your drawings, and you don't know, you don't care actually. When you don't care about the label position according to compass, and you have moved it, and then you update the detail drawing and the label will be moved back. This is the answer because of this option. So, as long as it's important for you to have the label arranged according to the compass, keep it activated. If this position is not important for you, then deactivate it, and then you can update the detail drawing without having this restriction to keep the label in that beam end. All right, I will close the model now, and with that I have concluded my presentation for this part. So we will go to the Q&A session. Ashley?
Thank you, Emmy. So at this time, we'll take some live questions. At the moment, there's only one in here, and it looks like Bogdan has already answered it. So I'll go ahead and read that so that everyone else can have it as well. So Jody was asking, if I have already customized my detail drawings in 2016, do I need to start from scratch again for 2017, or can I import them? And Bogdan answered that if you've already customized your own drawing styles, the easiest way to continue using them after upgrading your advanced deal version is to import the Astor add-in database to the new version. And on the Autodesk Knowledge Network, we also have plenty of resources on how to help you migrate your user settings as well.
Perfect. Okay.
And we have another one from Jerry. Hi, Jerry. And his question is, how does assembly CS affect mark location on plans?
Okay, the coordinate system of assembly. The detailed drawing is created, if I understand correctly the question, the detailed drawing, just one moment, in advanced deal, when you create an assembly drawing, you have this option, orientation of the beam end and orientation of the views. These two options, the combination of these two options, will decide how the beam or how the assembly will be shown in the detailed drawing, the orientation of the assembly in the detailed drawing. The easiest way at this point is to show the options orientation of the beam end. It means highest X, Y, Z coordinate and start point left side or start point right side. This is how the beam is oriented in the detailed drawing. And this will take into account the start point and the geometry of that element. And further, you have these options, beam front and beam top. The front and bottom and top of the assembly, it's dictated, it's set by the coordinate system, the assembly coordinate system. If you don't change it, if you keep the default orientation, then the orientation will be exactly like in this picture. If you use the option to modify the assembly detailing direction, then I will show you show assembly CS. This one will be the new front side. So to make it short, the orientation of assembly in detail drawing, it's composed by orientation of the beam end plus orientation of the view and then coordinate system. I hope I answered to your question. I think sometimes you need to test, just to test. But on this part, I think I can send you, I make a note. It's an article, a very good article that detail these two options, how they work. So then you can combine with the coordinate system and see and to predict the orientation of the assembly in your detailed drawing. Okay. Did I answer to your question? Hopefully.
I think so. And then okay. We have another question here. How can we dimension the knockoff dimension in assembly drawings?
I'm not sure I understand what it means knock dimension. I'm sorry if you can detail a little bit what it means. I will try to answer. However, if it's about dimensioning, I think we should cover this question during the webinar dedicated to dimensioning. All right, but if you can explain me what it means knockoff, then I will knockoff dimension, then I could try to answer. Okay. I see another question from Jerry Heath. From Jerry, where do I control the compass in the detailed drawings? In the detail, let me check again. Okay, so presuming that we have the compass inserted in the 3D model, we have this orientation according to the UCS at that point, then we go to drawing style, we go to the view, and we have, the view request. The drawing style is composed by several view requests. We go to each view request and we have this page, compass position. So it's next to this one, compass position. And we have a section dedicated to compass position in assembly drawing, and this one compass position in overviews. All right.
And then it looks like we have one other question here from Barry. Why are we unable to change detailing direction on folded plates?
The representation of unfolded, it's a special representation. How it shows not the element as it is in the 3D model, it's presenting the plate which is used to create the element. And as far as I know, I might feel I'm talking about over my head, but I think you cannot change it exactly because of that. It's a special representation and you cannot change it.
And it looks like that's all for the questions, Emmy.
I'm sorry, I didn't receive an additional anything. What it means knockoff dimension? So okay, maybe after that we will receive what it means. I'll try to search and I'll try to answer to that question. Okay. In that case, Ashley?
So we also have some additional resources for detailing customization that are specific to this webinar, and especially the first one on top, which is on our Advanced Deal Help page, labeling strategy. That one is an excellent resource and will be very helpful to you, as well as the other resources below.
Ashley, I may come back a little bit. I think the question from Barry, it was about folded plate, and I would like to add something. The orientation of the folded plate, it's imposed by the main fold. So just one moment. In the when you have a folded beam, I'll create quickly. When you have a folded plate, you have one element that it's the main fold, and this is the one that will decide the orientation in the detail drawing. And in the detail drawing, you'll see the unfolded shape of the entire folded plate based starting from this element. Okay, that was it. I hope I was the answer was more complete on this time.
He said it was very helpful, I mean, thank you.
Okay, please.
Okay, so these are resources specific for detailing customization, and we also have our general resources. We have the Autodesk University and our Advanced Deal YouTube channel, as well as on the Autodesk Knowledge Network. You can find plenty of information for Advanced Deal. All right, so for our last poll of the day, or actually of the year, is did you find this webinar helpful? And we'll give everyone a few seconds to get their answers in. All right, so it looks like most people found this webinar helpful. A few of you didn't, but thank you very much for sharing your feedback. And once again, thank you everyone for joining us and also for helping us to make these webinars a real huge success. And so we will be back in February of 2017, February 8th, for our next webinar, which is Customizing User Profiles in Advanced Deal 2017. And with that, I think we wish everyone a wonderful holiday season, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you all, and have a wonderful vacation. Bye.